I'll deal with the essential anatomy for Botox facial injections, and in this session, I will describe the muscles of the face, concentrating mainly on muscles of facial expression, which we are mainly concerned with, and I will discuss the anatomy of wrinkle lines in the face in relation to the muscles involved, preferred sites of injections, and possible complications. I will also outline briefly the blood supply and nerve supply of the face. This is to give you an outline of the arterial supply of the face. In the face, there are branches of the external and internal carotid arteries. The branches of the internal carotid artery are the supraorbital and supratrochlear arteries. The branches of the external carotid artery include the facial artery, the superficial temporal artery, and infraorbital artery. The facial artery enters the face by winding over the lower border of the mandible at the anterior border of masseter muscle. Here you can see it again. This is the facial artery in front of the masseter muscle, and you can feel the pulsations against the lower border of the mandible in front of the masseter. It is characterized by a tortuous course, and it ascends up toward the medial canthus of the eye, where it forms the angular artery and supplies the superior and inferior labial branches. The superficial temporal artery, its pulsations can be felt in front of the auricle, in front of the tragus of the auricle, and opposite the zygomatic arch. And at its beginning, it gives a transverse facial artery that passes beneath the zygomatic arch in association with the duct of the parotid gland. The facial vein, they correspond to the facial arteries. The facial vein starts as an angular vein and has a similar course to the facial artery, but is located behind the facial artery and is not tortuous like the facial artery. It has a straighter course. Here the superficial temporal vein joins the maxillary vein to form a retromandibular vein within the substance of the parotid gland, and this retromandibular vein has a posterior branch and an anterior branch which joins the fascia, and they drain into the internal jugular vein. The facial vein has deep communications with veins in the infratemporal fossa, and the angular vein communicates with the veins inside the orbit, and these eventually they communicate with veins inside the skull and into the cavernous sinus. That's why infection of the facial vein, which is for example initiated by squeezing of pustules on the side of the nose and the upper lip, may spread into the cavernous sinus, and hence this area here is called the dangerous triangle, including the upper lip. About the nerves, the motor nerve is the nerve, is the facial nerve, which is motor to the muscles of facial expression. The sensory is mainly by the trigeminal nerve. Trigeminal nerve, as the name indicates, has three divisions: the ophthalmic, maxillary, and mandibular divisions of the trigeminal nerve. So this is the area here, the area supplied by these three divisions. You'll see here that this is the area supplied by the ophthalmic division, and this is supplied by the maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve, and this is the area supplied by the mandibular division of the trigeminal nerve. Only a small area of the skin of the face that is located over the angle of the mandible is supplied by a cervical branch from the cervical plexus, which is called the great auricular nerve. The facial nerve, as it arises from the skull, the main trunk of the facial nerve, enters into the parotid gland, and within the parotid gland it divides and unites, and then we have five groups of branches that arise from the parotid, from the anterior border of the parotid gland, and these are the temporal branches, the zygomatic branches, the buccal branches, mandibular or marginal mandibular branches, and a cervical branch that supplies the platysma muscle. All these branches, they are motor to the muscles of facial expression. The cutaneous innervation on the face, as I said, it's provided mainly by the branches of the three divisions of the trigeminal nerve. I'm not going to go into all the details of these branches, but here we can see this is the, for example, the supraorbital nerve, the supratrochlear nerve. These are branches of the ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve. Also, we have the infratrochlear nerve and an external nasal nerve, a lacrimal nerve, all these five branches of the ophthalmic division of the trigeminal nerve. The maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve supplies an infraorbital branch, which as has been mentioned earlier, is located between levator labii superioris and levator anguli oris muscles, the infraorbital, which arises from the infraorbital foramen. And there is the zygomatico-temporal and zygomatico-facial nerves. All these three branches belong to the maxillary division of the trigeminal nerve. The mandibular division also has three branches: a buccal nerve, a mental nerve that arises from the mental foramen, and the auriculotemporal nerve that supplies the temple. Needless to say that the area that is over the of the skin that is over the angle of the mandible is supplied by the great auricular nerve from the cervical plexus. So this is just a brief account of the cutaneous innervation of the face.